Shalom, Kol Loyim La Yahu Bashim Yasha, Bashim Chakurash. That wants to my teachers, the elder apostles of the great millstone who rule well. And as always, peace, blessings, and salutations to all the fellow laborers of the old four-legged tabernacle of David's God throughout the four corners of the earth. Now, before I even play this clip, and this is from one of the old episodes of South Park, I want to get a quick scripture. And this is Isaiah chapter 47. And we're just going to go straight to the point. We're going to read the third verse. Real quick. We'll start off with that. Because, hey, you know, each day, you know, more layers of wickedness gets exposed. And that's what the Heavenly Father is doing. You know, lifting up the skirt of the great whore or mystery Babylon. All right. Every day is just newfound wickedness coming out. And that's all part of prophecy. Isaiah 47 and 3 says, thy nakedness shall be uncovered. Yeah, thy shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance and I will not meet thee as a man. You know, so one of the things the Lord was going to do as prophesied before he destroys this place was he's going to expose it. All right. And that's what you've been seeing, you know, since really since, you know, the World Wide Web came to fruition. Is one of the reasons why Jay Rockefeller said years ago, the internet should have never been invented. Because, you know, he didn't think that all his wickedness was going to, you know, come right before him. All right. Your iniquity, your sins are being revealed. And that's why the world is growing, you know, a hatred and a district, you know, nations don't really respect you like they used to. But anyway, you know, so we know that that's going to happen. And then the Lord is going to, you know, come and handle the rest. Right? He said, I will not meet thee as a man, meaning he's not going to spare you. And he's going to come with that angelic power. All right. So anyway, you know, Lord willing, they don't try to, you know, give me a copyright strike for airing this in the lesson, but you know I felt it was necessary to do a lesson because it just goes to show you, you know, how they'll really expose themselves. We're dealing with you know the pedal world amongst E. All right, the higher echelon of you know these people in the film industry, Hollywood. All right, and then you have these, you know, children programming networks such as Disney. And, you know, it's been exposed that, you know, we know for sure now that Disney is really a child grooming corporate pedophilia company. All right, and there's even been photos leaked showing Ghislaine Maxwell, all right, the madam to Jeff Epstein. You know, you have pictures of her hosting events, you know, at Disney. I think they called the event Happy Family Disney Day or something like that. It was back in like the mid-80s. All right. So it's all, you know, coming out, man. All right. Disney is a sick network. And really the other children's networks too, like Nickelodeon, all of them different child networks. It all has hidden, you know, pedophilia, you know, symbols. All right, a lot of hidden symbolism. You know, they did everything slick in a very subtle way. And your children, you know, sat behind the television and watched it. So now it's an uproar and people are protesting Disney ever since that leak meeting came out of how they want to plan to indoctrinate children with that mole lifestyle. So that's just another indication that this place is going to get wiped out. All right. And your shame is being seen before the whole world. So anyway, let's get to it. And then, you know, we'll hit some more precepts.
And cut. Great video shoot, guys. This is bullpucky. Yeah, we've had it, guys.
Now these three men are supposed to be the Jonas Brothers. All right, you know about the Jonas Brothers. They got their start on the Disney Network. They're a popular pop band. And one part of their act was when they would go out and perform, they would always have those purity rings on. But if you know about purity rings or chastity rings, you know, they're rings worn by young girls as a covenant or a signet of remaining pure and not, you know, laying with nobody until a marriage. You know, the Catholics, you know, that's what they do. But they wore it because it has a deeper, dark message behind it. All right? And you gonna see that. South Park pretty much exposes it. Show you how this is how they get down. See, what they show you, like in, you know, little cartoon shows like this on Comedy Central, you know, they usually will tell the truth. But because it's supposed to be dark humor, you wouldn't think it was the truth. You think that it's a joke. But that's the point. All right? What you think is a joke, what they're joking about or saying in jest, that's not really a joke. It's not too far from reality. So watch this real quick.
Darn it!
Uh-oh, looks like we've got a problem.
Our decision is final. We have decided, as a band, not to wear purity rings anymore.
Yeah, you tell them, Joe.
Boys, I know you're tired, but the purity rings are important to the company's image.
We don't care about the company.
And you're gonna say that to the boss's face?
We aren't afraid of him.
Well, I hope you're right, because the boss is on his way here. Now.
Oh, Jesus, he's here. Boss is here.
Let's be strong, guys.
Hello, sir. How was your trip?
What's all this I'm hearing about not wearing the purity rings, huh?
We'll just leave you alone.
So, I guess we have some issues, huh?
We need to talk about something.
Oh, boy. I just love flying all the way to Colorado to hear about your problems, huh?
Look,
little wicked mouse. You know, that's the boss right there. All right? Grilling the Jonas Brothers. All right, little Mickey, little Wicked. You know, if y'all have ever seen the meme, when you flip Mickey upside down, it actually spells Wicked. Let me see if I can find that. This devil shame, his disgrace is being exposed right now. But let me type it in. Mickey Mouse upside down. The images and look what you see. They're Wicked and yes, that whole network and everything that it represents is Wicked, man. But who owns the network? What people? All right, what people runs that network? The Wicked tells you that in was that Malachi 1 that there will be the border of wickedness. Let me get that. That's why everything they put their hands on, anything that they promote, push, condone, put in front of your face is always going to be wicked, man. Because these are wicked people. Malachi 1, and I'll start at verse 2. And it says, I have loved you, saith the Lord, yet ye say, wherein hast thou loved us? Was not Esau Jacob's brother? Saith the Lord, yet I loved Jacob, and I hated Esau. And laid his mountains and his heritage waste for the dragons of the wilderness. Whereas Edom said, we are impoverished, but we will return and build the desolate places. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, they shall build, but I will throw down. And they in the process of trying to build right now. They're trying to build their New World Order Tower of Babel. And the Lord's going to allow them to, you know, constructed and put it all together like they're doing right now. All right, rushing because they know that their time is short. But the Lord's going to throw it all down right when he's about to fill his belly. It says, and they shall call them the border of wickedness and the people against whom the Lord have indignation forever. All right? And you can't get around that. You know, for those of you that like to give Esau a pass, you know, you always trying to save him. He's not going to be saved, man. All right, he's a vessel of wrath fit to destruction. He's the son of perdition. So he's going to be destroyed whether you like it or not, man. He got to answer to all his wickedness in the earth. All right, he's on top. He's in power. So therefore, all the vibration of the world, you know, takes after his character, his nature. It tells you that he's a fornicator, somebody that's sexually immoral, all right, depraved. That's why he's the biggest pedophile, man. Heavy in the child abuse, sexual abuse. See? And they keep getting exposed, all these different pedophile rings. Hell, recently, I think it was sometime last year, that they actually they arrested some Disney employees. All right, because they was caught in a trafficking ring out there in Florida. So you had several Disney employees that got arrested. So these are some sick, perverted people, man. All right. So yeah, they're definitely wicked. Okay, and this is what Mickey Mouse represents. All right, and you see that they're trying to, push for those laws. I think it's one of the states is Tennessee, where they have this common marriage law, where there's no age limit to it, so even children can be liable for marriage. So they're making a push for it, man. Meanwhile, you know, everybody's upset. Them sicko liberals, and they all bummed out that DeSantis, and I think another state then adopted that "Don't Say Gay" bill. So they're just in an uproar because certain state governors are stepping up and not allowing for child grooming, because you already know what they're trying to groom your children towards. They're trying to get them ready for a 6'7", all right, a big gigantic ass linebacker with eyeliner to fondle your kids, man. That's what they're grooming them up for. Trying to put all them poisonous ideologies in their head. You're grooming them. So that's why this place gotta go, man. Children are not safe. They're trying to take away the innocence of children. So you know we ain't got a lot of time left, man. That day could be very close. So let's finish this video up, and then we'll get some more close out.
We just want our concerts to be about our music and not about purity rings.
Oh, gosh, fellas, let me explain this to you one more time. You have to wear the purity rings because that's how we can sell sex to little girls. See, if we make the posters with little girls reaching for your junk, then you have to wear purity rings or else Disney Company looks bad.
Well, we don't want to be selling sex to little girls anymore.
The rings stay on.
Well, maybe we'll just refuse to go on stage. Oof.
You don't talk to me like that, you little piece of sh! Get the f up! Get the f up! Now, do we have a problem?
No, sir. No, Mr. Mouse. No, Mr. Mouse.
Oh, that's good, because I thought we had a problem for a minute there, huh? All right, now, get out there and make me some goddamn money,
Yeah, that was a little Mickey Suge Knight Mouse. He's a Suge Knight at the Jonas Brothers. But hey, you know, this is dark humor, of course. South Park, you know, this is what they do. That's what they're known for. Very popular cartoon. I used to see it when I was younger, back in the late 90s. But this kind of scenario is not far-fetched at all. We know this is not too far from reality. All right, they got to tell you the truth, but they're going to do it in a comedic form. All right, but it clearly exposes that world, that realm. All right, Disney is a very satanic network, man. All right, and that's just more testament to the wickedness of Babylon the Great. And that's why the Lord, he said his eyes are upon a sinful kingdom. All right, let's get that real quick. Now, we know this, when you read it in its full context, is really talking about wicked Israelites, talking about the nation of Israel. But we know that America itself is a kingdom and it's very sinful, man. All right. And, you know, it's reaching new heights in wickedness. When we're talking about the land, all right, the valley of the shadow of death, man, where darkness is light and the light is as darkness. A land that's, you know, without order, man. All right. It's all wickedness. It's a safe haven for wickedness, man. Sin. All right. Debauchery. Okay. Amos 9 and 8, it says, behold, the eyes of the Lord power upon the sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it from off the face of the earth, seeing that I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob, saith the Lord. Because he's going to cut off 2/3 of our own people that are joined with this wicked society. You know, they would love to see it stand, and it's supposed to be the land of their captivity. They always regard it last. Everybody get they just due, everybody get their fair share, and then Jake is the last one that they would even consider. So the hell with this place, man. The Lord's going to destroy it off the face of the earth. He's going to lay it flat by way of thermonuclear destruction. Because her sins reached unto heaven, man. And it reached the skies. Let's see if I can find that. I think that's Jeremiah 51. Yeah, Jeremiah 51. And I'll start at verse 7. It says, Babylon hath been a golden cup in the Lord's hand that made all the earth drunken. Drunken with what? The wine of her fornication. All right. Drunk off the philosophy of the West. And in any place that partners up with this place, they compromise, you know, their belief system, their cultures. And they come and they commit fornication with the whore. And that means that you got to put away, you know, your moral principles, and you got to become completely degenerate, or you at least got to agree with it. Because here in Babylon, you know, like it tells us in Isaiah 59, you know, when one depart from evil, he makes himself a prey. You stand out, because it's all about sin and iniquity here. And we got to constantly be vexed like Lot with the filthy behavior of these wicked people, man. And the things that, you know, they get to do freely. And they're giving more and more push and power day by day with all these corrupt laws that they put in place to protect them. And it makes it no better now that you got this this pedophile sympathizer that in put into the Supreme Court, that, you know, a lot of these so-called black women are, you know, pulling their titties out for and you know, celebrating, trying to live vicariously through her. And we know when Esau put a woman, especially a so-called black woman, into a position as a Supreme Court judge, it ain't because of her greatness, man. And then because of how smart she is or none of that, you better believe that, man. All right. He knows that she's very loyal. So she's going to do whatever they tell her ass, man. But anyway, let's finish the verse. It says, the nations have drunken of her wine. Therefore, the nations are mad. Babylon is suddenly fallen and destroyed. How for her? Take balm for her pain. If so be, she may be healed. We would have healed Babylon, but she is not healed. Forsake her and let us go everyone into his own country, and her for her judgment reacheth unto heaven and is lifted up even to the skies. And the wickedness is great. The Lord's ready to thrust in that sickle and come down upon that wine press, man. All right, because you know it's the wickedness is great, man. It's abounding. Your children are not safe. You know they're gonna try to make it because it's an invisible P at the end of that abominable acronym. And we've always known about that. All right, at some point on the opposite end of this whole movement, they're gonna find a way to bring in the sickest of the sickest, man. Okay. So, you know, that's why this place is destined for doom. All right, and the Lord's gonna continue to expose it, and then he's gonna just lay it flat. Let's get Nahum 3. In verse 4 and 5, it says, because of the multitudes of the whoredoms of the well-favored harlot, the mistress of witchcrafts. And, you know, this Disney network was clearly, you know, full of enchantment and witchcraft, and is mainly geared towards the children, putting all those, you know, images in their head. And it programmed them and desensitized them, you know, to these particular dark things that they try to keep hidden. All right. They do a lot of predictive programming and all that. It's all to keep you desensitized. They normalize it. So the children are not going to think anything wrong because they're used to seeing it. And that's straight up witchcraft, man. So this place got to be taken out. It says the mistress of witchcrafts that sell up nations through her whoredoms and families through her witchcrafts. Behold, I am against thee, saith the Lord of hosts, and I will discover thy skirts upon thy face, and I will shew the nations thy nakedness and the kingdoms thy shame. And that's what we're witnessing, man. All right. Even your president, you know, that whole controversy with his son and what's in them laptops. They call it the laptop from hell. And Trump was trying to tell y'all about it, but y'all, you know, oh, QAnon, conspiracy theory, and all this other bullshit, you know, from the left. And it's not to defend Trump or anything, but he told y'all about it. And now, you know, the media, of course, being complicit, they're not going to keep up with what's going on. But you know, it's a lot of dark, twisted, warped shit that's associated with that. All right? But his son involving, you know, minors. And we know Sleepy Creepy Joe and his track record. All right, so you being exposed, your disgrace is being shown before the world. All right, he says, and I will cast abominable filth upon thee and make thee vile. We'll make sure everybody see how vile you truly is. And I will set thee as a gazing stock. All right, so, yeah, man. And it's why you devils are becoming more and more despised by the day. So, you know, I thought it would be interesting to do a response to this. You know, even though it was kind of funny, I laughed a little bit. But it's really not a joking matter. You know, this is for real. And they really exposed, you know, that network, that industry. This is how they get down. That's why you shouldn't have your children watching none of that crap. And also, it might be time for you, if you can, to pull your children out of them damn schools. Because it's just a breeding ground. It's to indoctrinate them and groom them up, you know, for this sick, twisted, warped, you know, sick old society, man. That's what they're grooming them up for. And we know the scriptures say, train up thy child in the way that he should go. And you're training them, you know, through the scriptures. Because this is our culture. This is our moral compass. This is our lifestyle. This is our belief, the commandments, the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High. All right? We're polar opposites of a wicked-ass E, who's naturally a fornicator and a profane person, a godless person. And the godless is who's ruling the world, and that's why so much wickedness is increasing. All right, let me get one more. Proverbs 29 and 16. And it says, when the wicked are multiplied, transgression increaseth, but the righteous shall see their fall. So we're going to see this wickedness get to, you know, unmatched levels in these last days, to where, you know, it's going to mess with you. It's going to spiritually agitate you. It's going to vex you. But, you know, we can't get too, you know, bent out of shape, because this is what to expect. This is what the Lord said would happen. That her iniquities is going to reach the skies, and it's going to be seen. And that's why he's going to destroy this place off the face of the planet. So anyway, I'm going to end off with that. I'm going to give all praise, glory, and honor to Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. And until next time, Shalom.